Finding your inner Neanderthal is definitely the most fun class, even though it's only once a week for 2 hours. I look forward to it every week.
A different way of connecting with the past is trying to sort of recreate it. And so the idea was, let's not just study the stone tools they made, let's see if we can make them to really gain an insight on how they did it. The Peabody Museum has fantastic collections of Neanderthal-made artifacts. We've been studying them, we've been looking at even fossil Neanderthals that are here.
It's a lot of hands-on learning, and every week is something new to look forward to and a new thing we're talking about.
Reading about things is great, but if I can do it, if I can touch it, if I can feel it, that is a sort of experience that I don't forget that.
There's something about hands-on making your own stone tools and stuff like that that we had looked at pictures of stone tools, but you don't really get a sense of what the process is like sitting in those chairs and actually like hammering out the stone tools.
Making stone tools is pretty tricky. You gotta at first make sure that you don't hit your own hand, because that's one of the biggest things. You get these rocks and you just think it's, oh, you just hit it and then it'll make a point. It's not really. It's almost like the physics of how you like need to hit certain parts of the rock to get it to be the way you want it.
We live in such a technological society that we lose sense of that technology is everywhere. And so by sort of immersing themselves in making what in some ways is the oldest technology, I think that's a really powerful way to sort of appreciate the past.